within on your God.
Thank you very much, Brother Simon, Chairman of the evening.
Praise God.
To the host, Pastor Reverend Dyer.
Yes, Lord.
Pastor Milton and all the other ministers of
yes,
the gospel.
Yes,
Christian friends and family in the Lord and to the Thanksgiving and our family. God bless you this evening. And I trust that the Spirit of Almighty God will continue to direct your lives. When I was invited, I said to myself, I will try to make every effort to be here. And he told me he would remind me. But it was last night that, thank God, I wrote it down in my Bible. And
praise God.
I was doing my Bible so I see the six of us.
Yeah.
I jumped.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let me first say peace be to this house and all who dwell in it.
Praise God.
Peace be to those who go out and come from this time forward.
Yes, Lord.
And even forevermore. I have heard the ministers preach this evening.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm thankful to God for what I have heard.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thankful to God for the declaration of the Thanksgiver.
Yes, Lord.
And I do hope and trust
mm-hmm.
that the little time that I would spend here before you this evening would certainly be beneficial to one and all.
Yeah.
When we call to remembrance, that is in the days of our fathers and grandfathers,
mm-hmm.
those of you who are younger.
Yeah, yeah.
And we recall the getting together to worship.
Yes, Lord have mercy.
There was always an aim.
Yeah.
And an objective.
Mm-hmm. Win souls.
Or a purpose.
Yeah, to win souls, man.
To the service.
Mm-hmm.
It was not for us to sweat and get wet.
Yeah. There was a purpose there.
Thank you.
It was not designed for us to ball
mm-hmm.
and fall.
Mm-hmm.
There was a purpose behind it. As a young man growing up,
yeah.
I recall very vividly that to every service that I attend, the focus was on backsliders
and unbelievers.
And unbelievers.
That's right.
To the hymns that was sung,
yes,
to the prayer that prayed,
yeah.
to the preacher who come in to preach,
yes.
there was an objective.
Yeah, praise God for that.
And so I heard in your declaration that you was alluding to the fact that it was 2 weeks you now started to go to church.
Yeah, yeah.
Bear with me for a little while.
Of course, of course.
And because of the gravity of the situation, because of the pain that your daughter
mm-hmm.
endured or undergone.
Yeah.
You didn't know Christ as yet.
Yeah, true, true.
But God, oh, Christ know you.
Yeah. Before you're born.
Mm-hmm. So he spoke to you. It's verse 27 of Mark chapter 10.
With man, it's impossible.
It is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. And you believe that.
Uh-huh. That's taking you through.
That's the message.
And as you believe that, you encourage your daughter
yes, boy.
To believe it.
To believe too, yes.
And because you prayed in your own simple way, you think, sometimes you think that is when we come of age and we could talk all kind of talk. And make all kind of repetition on our knees that we praying. But I hear right now say, praise the simplest form of speech. That the infant lips could try could because try. The infant does tell you things from the heart.
From the heart.
And sometimes we just laugh at what they say. Because they're so sincere with what they say.
So true.
And that is prayer when we could.
Yeah.
On bosom. But we have in our heart to Almighty God. And that be a result. And you testify this evening.
Yeah.
That because of this, you are giving God thanks.
Giving God
that
glory.
That is one of your testimonies.
Yeah.
Along the way, you have proven God.
In other ways.
In many ways. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord.
Yeah, true.
And so, this evening, your daughter and your children.
What Jesus.
Should have a relationship
with God. Oh yes.
And the preacher was right when he just said,
yes, Lord.
I will walk before the Lord.
Walk before the Lord.
Walking before the Lord, really, it's a word that is used interchangeably with living. I will live. That is what it means. It don't mean just. It means that we have to live in the presence of God. So that we could make a boast in the Lord. When Hezekiah called on God, he said, Lord, remember how I walked before you from the youth up. So he was saying, I was living a life to please you from the youth coming up. So now, I want you to have mercy on me.
Yeah, have mercy on me.
Loved brethren in Christ, it seems to me, I understand from a little boy growing up, I was in church. I was born in church and grew up in church.
Yeah.
So I understand the operation and I get baptized and I have a little experience, not much, just a little. But it seems to me in these last and closing days that we are comfortable with singing and shouting and the goodness of our service and the feel.
That's not all.
That is spirit and everything. Yeah. The spirit was in the place and that was good.
So true.
But I am here to tell you this evening, that is not good enough.
It is not enough. True, 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 true.
I'm here to tell you that Holy Ghost do not dwell in unclean vessels.
And this is true.
So you could ball and follow what you want.
This is very true.
You have to check yourself.
Yes.
To see the life that you're living.
All right, all right.
God bless us this evening.
Yes, Lord.
I come by to tell you this evening because the Bible says, how shall they hear without a preacher?
A preacher.
How shall they preach except they were sent? I was sent by God.
Yes, Lord.
And I come to tell you that in order for Holy Spirit to dwell in you, you need to have this vessel.
Yes, Lord.
Properly well cleaned.
Presented as a living sacrifice.
When you are born of the Spirit, when you live contrary, you just grieve the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, Lord Jesus.
That Spirit that you are sealed till the day of redemption, that Spirit is bearing record either for you or against you. What you don't know is that when the Spirit comes and he starts to tell you that voice.
Oh, Jesus.
That you keep saying, somebody tell me.
Yeah.
That you keep saying, hey, I know I'm supposed to do this and I am doing it. It's that little voice, the Spirit of God. Keep talking.
That's right. The
Spirit talk.
Don't
That's
go right. there. That's right. That's
Don't
right.
do that.
Yeah.
Don't say this.
Yeah.
Live right.
Lord Jesus.
And when you continue to ignore the Spirit, you know what the Spirit does?
Lord have mercy.
He withdraw. And he start to take record now.
Yeah.
Because you know why? He had to stand up before God and tell God
Lord,
that you didn't want to hear.
Yeah. Mercy.
To tell God that you was not subjected to the laws of God. So as the brothers say, how one saved could always be saved.
Yeah, very true. Very
true. We want
true.
To live our filthy life.
Yes.
Yes. One saved could never be.
No.
Always saved. Mm. So the Spirit of God is for us so that when you reach home to glory, it is not you, it's the Spirit of God.
Yes, that will be taking you home. Yes, Lord.
You know what Jesus told his disciples? When the Spirit has come upon you, the first thing you're going to do is be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and then the uttermost part of the world. So your first step is to tell people about Jesus.
I don't care how much you're for.
Oh, Jesus.
If you haven't reached the place yet to tell people how sweet the name of God have mercy.
Yes, Jesus.
Of Jesus' song. You don't understand yet the operation of the Spirit.
Yeah.
We are seeing nobody getting healed.
Yes. Very true.
Full of Spirit.
This is so true. This is so true. Yes. There are some
what are you with me this evening?
There are some signs that will follow it.
All we want Spirit to do is to feel good.
Yeah. He could do more than
but
that.
But these are the signs that will follow them and believe
very
in my
true.
Name.
Yes.
You will lay hands on sick.
And they will recover.
They will recover.
Yes, man. Yeah.
If you drink any deadly poison,
it will not harm you.
Nothing will happen to you. Yeah. Know why? Because of the Holy Ghost that dwells within you.
Yeah. We know
to why is it that all we want Spirit to do?
Yeah, that is true.
To sing and shout.
That is so true. He could, yeah. Very
why
true.
Why is it when we go to somebody's house to pray for us?
Yeah. Yeah.
They can't get delivered.
Yeah. True. Very true. Amen.
That is for us to understand.
Understand.
That the Spirit of God is given unto us for more purpose than just
very
what
true.
We are doing.
So true. Very true. And he could do so many other things.
When we start to walk in the Spirit,
mm-hmm. yes,
we will not fulfill the lusts of the flesh.
Thereof.
Romans 8 tells us that.
Yeah.
For they that are in the flesh do mind the things of the flesh. For they that are in the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. To be carnally minded.
Yes, Lord. So true.
So God wants us to come out from that place. That you could get in your home. I often tell people this. When them boys were small and they get sick, I never go to no doctor. But if I wanted to go, I could go. I had no money to carry them.
Yeah.
But I take them up in my arms and I turn to the east.
Yeah.
And I summon heaven.
Yeah.
And all of them get better.
Praise God. Yes. Praise God.
I'm telling you.
Yeah.
Because you're full of Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord.
And as your head hurts you, you run to casualty.
Yeah.
In fact, you're calling for EHS.
Yeah. True. Not supposed to
and
be
you're
so.
Full of Holy Ghost.
You're not supposed to be so.
Call on God first.
That's right. That's right. Amen.
Call on God first.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Sometimes the thing just come and it's not that. As the brother was saying, is a spirit what just passed, you know. But because you're so weak, the spirit kept inside you, and you think it's so much as your pressure going up, your sugar going up.
Lord have mercy.
You're almost in a coma.
Lord have mercy.
And when you reach, for them to diagnose your complaint, they can't find
nothing.
No problem.
Thank you. Very true. Yeah.
You don't understand that it's a spirit.
It is a spirit. Amen. Amen. Amen.
This evening, we come in a good place.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
When the sister said that she called on the Lord because she believed the word. With God, all things are possible. And she's the result in her home. That should tell you and I that God could do it.
God could do it.
There is no problem. There is no situation. There is no sickness that God don't have the answer or the remedy for. So we could go to God. We could approach our soul to the mercy seat. And he will hear and answer our prayer. You know why? Because we have access to the Spirit of God. If we don't reach to that place, boast how much we want to boast. If we don't reach to the place, the Bible says that when Peter and the walk, the very shadow
is a hill.
God have mercy. When the shadow fell on people, they were healed. Because they believed these fellows were filled with the Holy Ghost.
Oh, Jesus.
We want to see evidence of the Spirit in us today. Bible say these are the signs that will follow. What sign mean? It means you must see something. Don't let nobody fool you. When you operate in the Spirit, souls will be born
to call
the blessed. Call God's name blessed. That is what we want. If there's not anybody in this house, when the service comes back, somebody needs to identify with Jesus.
Oh, you.
forgot to press one on my suit. I'm not carrying any laundry for free. No.
Come on, have a laundry man.
Somebody need Jesus.
Have a laundry man. Have a laundry man.
I said, somebody needs to know who is the man from Galilee. Somebody needs to know.
Yes,
this
sir.
Lord have mercy.
Yeah,
we go on that divine victory and we pray and we grow and we get in contact with Jesus and we come back out. We could tell
hey.
Them. As by the light of open day, the stars are all concealed. So let the pleasures fade away when Jesus.
Oh God!
Come out today to rejoice with his sister and the family.
Yeah.
Because I walk all day. Doctors have said some kind of thing in the left right here.
Yeah, boy.
That's so many things to bring up. That's only a year after. What a
three.
Yeah? 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 How I could get a heart attack? I cannot tell you how that I give Jesus my heart. How I could get a heart attack?
Yeah.
Devil will pass by
your doctrine. Oh God, no
one can see that. You hear what I'm saying?
Yes, man, that's a free blue.
Yeah. I say the devil will pass by.
Yes, sir.
And when the believers come by the bedside and start to pray, some of them start to pray and groan. We get strength to fight the enemy. Yeah. I don't take tablets.
Yes.
I said, when you wrapped up in God, you have a guide. You have a glory. And you have a defense. He is your rock. I said, he is your shield.
Not to fear, because people killing people all over the place. You're fearful and you have
your captain whose name is Jesus. Let me tell you something. When you walk in with Holy Ghost and you start to walk.
And you go back home here. Is the spirit
I but me and no how on earth you know? I me know what make me turn back. You're going for destruction, but the spirit make you turn back. You will not acknowledge the spirit of God in your life. But me and no what make me turn back. How you ever? And you turn back, look, destruction waiting right there for you.
Yes, sir.
Watch on your foot.
All you have to do is live for him.
Yes,
yeah, that's all.
You look like the people of the world. We have a problem, proof up and all kind of thing, and you make all kind of different paraphernalia because you're afraid.
True.
Bandit come out. Hey, let me tell you something, man. I read it in this psalm. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall live under the shadows of the Almighty.
He tells you something, you forget that Lord. You know, I got no problem.
Boy, you leave the door open.
Gosh. Anything wrong with you? Anybody coming here?
I would give the bandit or the thief an invitation to come in my house that you know wisdom. But if I forget it, the Bible says if you drink any deadly poison, you say, go and drink. Or if you drink, you're hearing what I say, man. I say if you drink, nothing will happen because you have the Holy Ghost. So we need to get the Holy Ghost.
I want to close with this. We believe the Holy Ghost is our teacher. We believe that the Holy Ghost was the book. We believe that the Holy Ghost fixed the business. We believe that. Then we must make sure that we have the Holy Ghost. Don't take it for granted that you have the Holy Ghost. Go to God in prayer until God answers you.
Yes,
because I tell you this, if you miss heaven, you wouldn't miss heaven.
Oh, Jesus.
That's nothing to take for granted.
So true.
You have to make sure when Peter and they ask them, Since you're baptized, have you received the Holy Ghost? They say, what Holy Ghost? We never even hear about the Holy Ghost. Palace to be receive one. He said, well, they don't know what to you baptized. And then he prayed for them and they received the Holy Ghost. And it's so important, the Holy Ghost. They receive the Holy Ghost. Jumping up and preaching, we could be singing, we could be shouting, we could be praying. If you don't have the Holy Ghost,
thank you.
You will hear on that morning, is that what identifies you as a child of God?
Oh, Jesus.
If a man have not the Spirit of God, he is none of his.
None of his.
So we could be how good we want in the church.
Oh, yes.
So God has us to be in a good place this evening in Sister Val's home.
Thank you, Lord.
To hear the testimony. Testimony. I hope some believers. You know, sometimes we build a nice house and furnish it and it's looking good. We buy a nice vehicle and all of that. And we want to be God's hands. Because we have these things. Nothing wrong with that, you know. But when you could see evidence of the saving grace,
oh God, that will be talking about.
Of how God operates and heal your daughter. Yeah. Hey, this is nothing material. Yeah. This is from God
that
himself.
That is so true.
Where the doctors couldn't operate, where the doctors couldn't, Lord have mercy, they couldn't find an answer. When the doctors fail, here comes Jesus. I am the Alpha. I am the Omega. I am the beginning. I am the end. I am the first. I am the last. I am he that was dead. And behold, I am alive. Forevermore are the keys of death. Here comes Jesus. All power.
All power.
Have God for you and your family. Continue to live for Christ. Continue to testify. You know when God do a good work in
your life,
don't keep it for yourself.
Yeah, man, share it.
Always tell people, God is good. My daughter would have been dead today. But for the grace of God.
But for the grace, man.
Always tell people,
yes,
I would not have been alive today.
Yeah.
But for the
grace of God.
Oh,
Jesus.
And when you see my birthday come around and I decide to give thanks.
Yeah.
I ain't giving thanks because I want your money.
No.
I'm giving God thanks because
what he did.
He spared my life.
So true. And he healed you.
People,
he healed you.
They feel that because you come to a Thanksgiving, my Thanksgiving, and somebody decide to pick up our offering.
Lord have mercy.
Some people say,
yeah.
You came down for money. Me?
Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, we.
Sister Val, let me tell you something. I'm self-employed.
Yeah.
My Saturday day work is more than $1,000.
Praise God. Praise God.
When I leave that to come to your Thanksgiving, is because I consider you.
Yes, man. Aye, aye, aye. Yeah, Jesus.
You're walking nowhere, you know?
Yeah. yes, of course.
Depend on a Saturday.
Yeah.
It's more than $1,000.
Praise God.
If you have to ask somebody for something to give me for my Thanksgiving.
Yeah. You work for it.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, man.
So I'll come and after I make all things for you to eat and drink, I pick up a collection for you to give me money.
Mercy.
I wonder if you understand what you're saying.
Yeah, out of timing, man.
When I understand how good God has been to me and he's spared my life again.
Yeah.
I'm bound to give
you're
God
to give God thanks.
Yes. I don't give him thanks.
Yes, man.
I don't praise him. I don't honor him. And this must be your attitude. You must have an attitude of gratitude.
Oh, Jesus.
Always to praise God.
Praise God.
Because he was good to you and your family.
Yes, man.
But I still be groaning.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I still be crying.
Yeah, Jesus.
Every injection what she get and it has some needle long and long.
Yeah, the long and the hot in. Truth. The hot in, yes. Truth. In
the hospital. They hit me some of that injection.
It's true.
When they come to give me that groan.
Yeah, and it hot. It hot in too bad, you know.
Take it like a man.
Yeah.
Take it like a man.
Yeah, it hot in we.
Take it like a man. You dread when that hour comes because that going down in the bone, you know.
Yeah, man. You need a long.
I could identify with what your daughter said.
So true.
What she was going through because I was there.
Yeah.
So know that God is good.
Yeah.
People, God is good.
Yes, man.
Man.
Oh, Jesus. So true.
Oh, Jesus. The simple.
Yes, Lord.
When I was broke, Lord, he helped me.
Yes,
so
Lord.
So return unto thy rest, O my soul. For the Lord hath dealt bountifully with me.
Oh Jesus.
Deliver mine eyes.
Oh Jesus. Keep my feet from falling.
Groaning on the hospital, can you feel it easy?
Yeah. Mercy. Yeah.
Thank God for Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
When people pass through situation and you come to rejoice,
yeah,
because you pass through something yourself.
That's right. So you could identify with them. Yeah.
When I shout and I call,
yeah,
I understand with you identifying them because
oh,
I know,
Jesus.
Hey, I know what God did for me.
Yes, Lord. So yeah. True.
So come on, rejoice with woo. Me. Yeah. For once I've found a friend.
Aye, aye, aye.
Lord, my heart,
more secret depth.
Yet you love me without him.
Jesus.
We need Jesus in this company.
Yes, Lord.
Anybody in this house who I know Christ yet?
Yes, yes, man.
Casting your lot to the people of God. You see me come here this evening to make big up the name of Jesus.
Yes, man. Oh, Jesus.
In a weary land. I say he's a shelter.
You need time and storm.
Who needs Jesus? Sometimes we play that we don't understand. Hey, that the man of all power. He has remedied us in every condition.
That's right.
And we fretting as we hear. We get sick. Let me tell you something. I have a sister in the States. She has stage 4 cancer.
Lord have mercy. We? I don't wish that on nobody.
I didn't have nobody.
Oh, Jesus.
Could be more encouraging than that.
Yeah. Lord, have mercy.
Sometimes I call and I pray on you.
Yeah.
Sometimes I use the WhatsApp.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Communicate.
Yeah.
So here what happened. I have 4 sisters in this state.
All right.
I allow one. She gets sick. Some kind of throat. Cancer.
Lord have mercy.
She born in the hospital. So the eldest one carry her in the hospital. I'm not talking about the one who had cancer.
Alright.
I'm talking about 2 others.
Yeah, okay.
And while she was in the hospital with the next sister, she feel her foot getting heavy.
Alright.
Sit down, she fall down.
Yeah.
They had to put her in a wheelchair.
Mm-hmm.
Give her IV, whatever. Mm-hmm. Fix her and carry her in the next hospital. Is a stroke, she get her stroke.
Lord have mercy. Yeah, Lord have mercy.
No, you want to say. So the well carry the sick in the hospital. And the well gets sick in the hospital. So 3 of them sick over.
Lord have mercy,
we? Know who Jesus is.
Yes, man. Oh, Jesus.
Yes, sir. I said, Lord, sickness. What he did in bygone days.
Woo.
I know he can do today.
Yes, Lord.
So we have faith. Many are the days.
Yes.
I saw a young girl, she came from the States, and my sister sent something to me. So I went up and I did, and she told me, she said, that child is like a mother to me. My children, her children, I said, mommy, look, the ladies, an elder lady that knew how you talking to her.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
She said, freezing when the place very cold.
Yeah.
And people staying home. Get ready, let me go to church.
Lord have mercy. You see courage? Aye, aye, aye.
And she said,
so true.
Sometimes,
yes, we don't even have
you allow
the
sickness.
Yeah.
To get control of you.
That's right.
Before you use your faith.
Yeah, that's right.
And say in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Rise up. And you're telling me you're serving a true and living
true
God.
True and living God.
Which true and living God?
Yeah, but no power.
We need to prove it.
Prove
it, God. It doesn't mean nothing will come. Don't tell yourself.
Yeah.
It's going to come.
It's going to come,
because
yeah.
A child of God is not saying the enemy going to throw after you. Yeah. You just say, well, one finish. Lie down and you flow and you relax and you
so
stretch
true.
Out.
So true.
Before you stretch out
the
next one.
That's
right. Well,
see.
Because the enemy do not want you to make it to heaven.
Yes, Lord.
So he wants to discourage you. But I hear what when John said he sits right out. You're going to be with me
and then
he said,
no evil.
Oh, Lord.
No evil.
How much you went through already?
Oh, Jesus.
Seven,
Lord have mercy.
I want to read the 7 decrees yet.
Woo!
We still down here, man, because we go still bad talk and we have effects for that.
That's yeah, right, that's right.
We move over that plane.
This is true, this is true.
Let them talk, man. They say what's that about you.
Yeah.
And you praying, and you rejoicing, and them eating up themselves, and you rejoicing.
Yeah.
And you giving God the thanks, and you giving God the praise, and the honor and the glory, and they can't understand. Hey! And they eating up themselves.
Eating up themselves. And you will have time. You have time.
You're reaching that plane.
Thank you. Talk to them all for
you. You don't move from time. That level. Yeah. Thank you, Peter.
Yes.
So you don't move from that level.
True.
It's different heights.
Yes.
It's different degrees. When you reach in that level, you start to say, the worm destroy my body.
Oh, God.
I say, yet in the flesh.
Yes.
I'm going to see God.
Lord, I'm going
to see God.
Yeah.
I'm going to see him for myself. I'm not for another. Because I know that my Redeemer lives. And he's going to stand for me. Until latter day. When you're studying your problem, you can't say that.
Yeah.
When you're worried and you're murmuring and complaining, you can't say that.
Yeah.
But when you're thinking about Jesus, you say, the worm destroy this body.
Yeah.
Yet in the flesh, I will. Is that some sick when you go to visit them? Them encouraging you?
Yes, yeah. Yes, yeah. Yes.
Boy, them is people who reach certain degrees.
That's right, that's right.
If you have anybody in this company this evening, don't let all this gospel
pass
you by and you're just going back home without understanding that you are in the presence of the King of Kings and
boy.
The God of Lords.
Woo.
That you are in the presence of the Lord have mercy. The mighty healer, the great physician. He could change situation. He could get in your heart, perform an operation, and come back up without putting you to sleep.
Lord have mercy.
Yes.
You have to go under no anesthesia.
Lord have mercy. Okay.
You hear what I say?
Yeah.
When he performed that surgery on your heart, you're a different person.
Yeah, the doctor don't understand it.
Anybody
want Jesus.
You in the kitchen, you in the bedroom, you outside, you want to pray?
Yeah.
Come on.
You know why I just challenge people?
Yeah.
Because you want to go back home. You come here, you want to go back home with your problem, go back home.
Praise God.
But I will challenge you because I know the God what I serve.
Ah, Jesus.
That's why I just ask.
Yeah.
You come. Lord have mercy. Jesus standing in your presence. And you walk away with all your problems. And then you say, Lord, pray for me. Pray for me. Not me. You are talking to me. I know ask if you were her. I know ask you that. God bless you, your man.
Praise God. Yes, Lord.
Our life could be more enriched.
That's right.
Because the Holy Ghost is present here in this house. Go around and tell people, I tell you, because you're singing and shouting your Holy Ghost, don't go and tell nobody that, you know.
Merci.
I know how people is.
Yeah, true.
Don't go and tell nobody that, you know.
Yeah.
I never tell you that, you know.
Yeah.
I say Holy Ghost is much more
than singing. Yes.
And shouting.
True. Sometimes we lack understanding
we
of the word.
Somebody may come bleeding.
Yeah.
And they need a touch from God.
Yeah.
Somebody may need to identify themselves because they have tried everything.
That's right. That's right.
Now they need to know that they didn't try the one thing that could get them some results. That's Jesus.
Yes, man.
They have been trying religion. They're going to this church and they're going to that church and they're running from church to church because somebody say, bring a glass of water.
Yeah. Mercy.
Mm-hmm.
And that's important.
Somebody say, bring some salt.
Bring a handkerchief.
Oh, Jesus.
Somebody say, bring a handkerchief. Get something and wave. And they're running with it because they're trying,
yeah, of course.
It's trying, they're trying. They're getting you there. And then, you have the one that tell you, hear what I could help you.
Yeah.
I could charge you no more.
Yeah.
But I want you to buy some things. And the things that you have to buy cost $1,000.
Lord have mercy.
You have to put in a little while also. Now what he could buy, though, that had to be diamond. You fit in that little
I feel so. Because that's too much money.
I am charging you, you know, but the price of the things that they had to buy.
Yeah.
He said, if it will come back, you would demand anything, but I am charging at all.
You hear the lie? True. You hear the lie? Yeah.
He could.
Too much lie.
Don't take your money.
Yeah.
And that's what people looking for, the quick fix. So God bless you. Anybody else pumping? Anybody else?
Yes, man.
Get some light for yourself. Come quick. Praise the name of the Lord. God bless you. Anybody, you're outside, you're in the kitchen, you're in the bedroom.
Yes, man.
And you are hearing the sound of my voice, and you need prayer. Come now. Now is the time. Living in crucial time. Not yesterday or the day before, they find a man.
Yeah.
In Stanleyville. At the end of the track. I know where Stanleyville is. And his head was to the side of his body.
Lord, have mercy.
They put over your head up, way down to the side of your body. Right inside my name.
Yeah. True, true, true.
I said people have their wicked.
Oh, Jesus.
Desperately wicked. They had no compassion for man again.
Oh, Jesus.
You need to be covered with the blood of Jesus. When the presence of Jesus will respond.
Oh, yes.
Already interfere with I want you to help me, bro.
Raise it up.
I want you to worry about yourself. This NOC meeting. This is all. Let me explain it to you. Jesus said, and Lord, let me point in the name of the Lord. If you confess your sins before God, the prophet will the same, the sick. And God will hear the prayer. God going to answer your prayer. You don't believe in simony. It's documented in the scripture. That's why we have consecrated oil. And you know why I walk in that home with the McIntosh? By the way, when I reach your church, I pray for anybody, anywhere.
Yes, thank you. I want to pray that.
You ministers who lend me some your assistance, I just want you to put your hands on them. Just go and rest your hands on them. Praise the name of the Lord. This is your point of contact. Praise the Lord. And if this is your point of contact, this Holy Spirit of God will take your position and carry it to you. Identify your God, and I know that you are even disappointed. You say, as many as come to you shall be no one. Cast them out. And if they call on you, you will answer. So pray in the name of Jesus that you will administer to these
confidence in you. We put our
trust in you. Great Elohim tonight. Hey, ha. Hallelujah. For in the principalities and powers, for his sake, in the name of Jesus. Anointing with the heavenly grace and sealing for your holy in the name of the Father. In the name of the Son. In the body.
Thank you, Jesus.